If you want to be able to modify the data using mutations for your Nest.js GraphQL API, in this Quick Tips episode, you will learn how. Keep watching. Hi there. I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So, if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start! In the previous videos, I created a simple Nest.js server that returns a list of quizzes with nested child questions. In this video, I will create mutations to allow the client to modify the data inside our Nest.js application. Add to the quizzes service a toggle shuffle answers method that receives the ID of the quiz. Within the list of quizzes, look for the first quiz that has a matching ID. Toggle the shuffle answers field and return the modified quiz. Then, on the quizzes resolver, add mutation, args, and int to the Nest.js GraphQL imports. Using the mutation decorator configured to return a single quiz, create a method called toggle shuffle answers. For the parameters, use the args decorator and set quiz ID for the name and int for the type. From the quizzes service, called the toggle method, pass the quiz ID, and finally return the modified quiz object. Finally, restart the server. Go to localhost /GraphQL, which will open the GraphQL playground inside your browser. Create a new tab. Type mutation, and following a similar syntax as for the query, type the name of the mutation, toggle shuffle answers, and inside parentheses, type the name of the parameter, quiz ID, a colon, and the ID for the quiz that we want to modify. Finally, provide the fields that you want to be returned after the quiz has been modified. In the next video, I will talk about sending more complex parameters to our Nest.js application. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.